Hello, dear friends. As you remember, my name is Dinara, and today it's a very important lesson because today we're going to start teaching you Chinese grammar. And our teacher is Jiang Kaiyang. Hello.
Hello, everyone. 我叫江凯阳，大家好。
老师, what topic are we going to study today?
So today's topic is about word order of Chinese sentences, and you can use it to make a simple introduction of yourself. So I'm going to explain the sentences in three different parts. The first part, I will explain the sentence structure. And the second part will be the function. And the last part, we will do some exercises.So that you can know how to use it in our daily life. So if you just started to learn Chinese language, or you have learned Chinese language for a certain period of time, you may notice that most of the Chinese sentences belong to this simple structure, subject, predicate, and sometimes is object. So, but do keep in mind that predicate is not only includes the verb,And sometimes it includes adjective and nouns. So actually, Chinese basic sentences structure, there are four structure. The first structure and also the most common way is subject, verb, and object. And the second one is subject, adjective. And the third one is the subject and nouns. And the last one is subject and verb.
I have a question. It is possible to have sentences without verbs in Chinese.
Yeah, it can be without verb in Chinese. It's just like the second structure of the sentences, just the subject and the adjective. It's without verb. And the subject with nouns is also without verb. So it works. So I can give some examples so you may not be confusing. For example, the first structure is subject,verb and object. In Chinese, we say that 主语、谓语、宾语. So it's like 我喜欢你. It means I like you. Or 我爱中国. I love China. So I is subject, love is verb, and China is object. So the second structure of the Chinese sentence is subject.And adjective. In Chinese, we say that 主语和形容词. For example, 今天天气很热 or just 天气很热. It means the weather is hot. The hot is adjective. The weather is subject. And the third structure of the Chinese sentences, it will be subject and noun. In Chinese, we call that 主语和名词.For example, 今天是星期六 or just 今天星期六 It means today is Saturday. And the last part of the Chinese sentences is...
老师, I didn't know that it is possible. I thought that we always need to say 今天是星期六. So in this case, we can say 今天星期六, 对吗?
对, that's right, that's right. You can just say, 今天星期六, you can, 是, it's a verb. It's not necessary to say 是. Of course, you can say, 今天是星期六, it's right. But you can also say, in a short way, 今天星期六, it's more simple.
So this simple way of saying without a verb, is it more oral?
Yeah, it's more oral. For example, I ask you a question, 请问Dinara, 今天星期几? How to answer the question?
星期六。
Yeah, 星期六 is more oral, just 星期六。Or you can say 今天星期六。
And for example, if I write in the exam, I have to write 今天是。
You mean the question it will be 今天星期几? And you answer 星期六。I can't say it's not right. That's right. Just if today is not Saturday, you are wrong. So if today is Saturday, you are right. But you can also write 今天是星期六 is also, but just you have said that it's more oral. 星期六 It's just the answer of the question, the main part of the question. So you just can answer 星期六. All right. So I have explained it for basic structure of Chinese sentences. So today's topic, we are concentrated on the first and the most common structure sentences. It will be the subject, the verb, and object. In Chinese, it's like 主语, 谓语, 和宾语. So let's move on the second part. It's a function. So when you first meet some interesting Chinese people at schools or in the company or even on the street, and you want to make sure that people know who you are, and you learn to use these three simple verbs, 姓 and 是, and the last one is 叫. So let's move on the first verb, 姓. It means surname, but in Chinese, it helps us to introduce one's surname. For example, my surname is Jiang, but remember that it's just not like English surname, 姓 in Chinese, both as a verb or as a noun. So as a noun, it means surname or your last name. So for example, my surname is Jiang. So you can translate word by word like my, 我的, surname, 姓, is, 是, 姜. So 我的姓是姜. But in Chinese, we often use it as a verb form. For example, also the same sentences, my surname is Jiang. You can translate like, 我姓姜. So in Chinese, 我姓姜. So in this case, 姓 is a verb. 动词, in Chinese it's 动词.
It's like an English word, love. It can be noun and it can be a verb.
Mm-hmm. So this is the verb 姓, just your surname, 我姓姜. So how to make a question of these sentences? If you ask you, for example, what is your surname? In Chinese, we see that if you translate word by word, it will be 什么, what, 什么, is, 是, your, 你的, surname, 姓, so, 什么是你的姓, or, 你的姓是什么, it's more better because in Chinese language, I have said that the common structure is that first places is the subject, and then is the verb, and then is the object. So, when you make questions, it's also the same word order. The first place is 你的姓, and then the verb is, and the last part of the sentences is what, 什么. So 你的姓是什么? Or just you can say 你贵姓, 您贵姓. It's more, if you want to be more polite, you can say 您贵姓. If you just ask 你的姓是什么? It's just like a common, it's a normal way. But if you want to be more polite, for example, when you meet your teacher, your grandfather, or some people that elder than you, you can ask 你贵姓? It will be more polite.
贵 in this case means expensive.
Yes, 贵, it means expensive, but you can't translate what is your expensive surname. That's not right. It's just like, what is your surname? The same. If we translate in English, it's the same. But in Chinese, 您贵姓, it will be more polite.
In this case, Gui, I think it means more like respect. What is your respectful surname? Yeah, or like,
yeah.
What is your dear? What is your dear surname?
Mm-hmm.
Dear. In English, people say dear Dinara, dear Kayang.
Just like you said, it's respect way. 您贵姓?
So it is always better to say, to be polite with elder people.
Mm-hmm.
And say 您贵姓.
Yes.
Can I say 您贵姓 to you, for example, my colleague?
Yeah, you can say that.
And the simplest way to ask somebody's surname is 你姓什么?
你姓什么? It's a simple way. It's a simple way. Everyone can ask this question, but just like a common question. 你姓什么? But it's not so polite. For example, if we are colleagues, we are classmates, I can ask 你姓什么? We are friends. We are friends. We have the same age. Although we don't know each other, but we can just ask. 你姓什么？Okay. This way can also be polite. How to say? Just exchange the first characters. 你 exchange 您。您姓什么？ It's also applied. A little bit polite form. But the most polite form is 您贵姓。
Okay, guys, I would like to remind you that in Chinese, we have you for people like the same age people, and we have you for people who are older than you, or like you want to show respect, and or maybe you do not know each other yet. So in this case, in Chinese, we say 您, it's like very polite you. People who studied Spanish, it's like usted in Spanish.
So we have explained the how to express your surname. So what about your full name? You can use the second verb. In Chinese, we called it 叫. It means to be called. For example, my name is 江凯阳. So you can translate 我叫江凯阳. So 江凯阳 is my full name. 姓 is includes my surname and my first name. So you can use these characters, this verb 叫 to say your full name. Some people may be asked that, so if I just want to say my first name, how to say that? That is so interesting because I have seen a lot of resources that said you can also use 叫. After 叫, you can place your first name after the verb 叫. But I don't agree with that because in Chinese, we often say my surname is Jiang and my first name is Kai Yang. So in Chinese, 我姓江一名凯阳名, we use another word, another characters, 名, 名字的名. It's more useful, it's more oral. So we don't say that 我叫凯阳. It's sometimes it's a little bit strange. So just remember that we use this 叫. And after 叫, please put your full name.
So, guys, let me explain that in China, people, when introduce each other, they always say first their surname and then their name, mm-hmm. and their second name.
Yes.
Why? Because family values, they are very strong in China.
Mm-hmm.
And in this way, they show that they are part of this family.
Mm-hmm.
Cultures a bit in some parts different. And in mm-hmm. this case, I think that the same was so some time ago in England, in the US, and other European Western countries.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So how to ask question about the sentences 我叫江凯阳, how to ask questions? You can ask
叫什么?
你叫什么? Good. 你叫什么? In English, it's what's your name? In Chinese, 你叫什么? 你叫什么? It's also the same if you translate word by word. It will be what 什么? Is 是 your 你的 name, it means 名字. So it's like 什么是你的名字? But in Chinese, this way is also right. We can say this question, but we may often use another way, just like what I have said. The first position is subject. So 你叫什么名字? So subject, verb, and object.Okay, so this is the second part of the verb. So you can use 叫 to say, to express your full name. And if you want to express your, just your first name, you can use another characters, 名. 我姓江,名凯阳. It's like that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so the third verb is 是. It means to be. In English, do keep in mind that the full name can also be placed after 是. For example, I am 江凯阳. In Chinese, mm-hmm. 我是江凯阳. That's also right.
Mm-hmm.
You may ask me question. It will be that, do they have any difference between 叫 and 是? Because 叫 can also put your full name, and 是, it can also put your full name. So what's the difference mm-hmm. between the 叫 and shi.
I think no difference.
Actually, of course, they have difference. They have different exercises, but in some times they are exchangeable. Just like this ways, 我叫, 以我是, 以 after that, put your full name. But remember that after verb 是, you can also to put your title. For example, Mr. or Mrs. It's like, 我是江先生, Mr. in Chinese, 先生. So your surname and your title, Mr. It means, I am Mr. Jiang. Or, 我是李女士. It means, I am Mrs. Li. So, except for that, you can also put your profession after the verb 是. For example, you can put the word teacher or manager or engineer. For example, I'm a teacher. Or to say in Chinese,
我是老师。
我是老师, right? Or I am a teacher. 我是一名老师, 我是一名老师。Or I'm a manager. It's like, it will be, 我是一名经理, or just, 我是经理。Or I am a engineer. 我是工程师。我是工程师。Yeah. So the third way is, you can use verb 是 to answer the question, where are you from? 你是哪里人? You can answer, I'm Chinese. It means, 我是中国人. So you can see the difference between the verb 叫 and 是. They have different exercises, and the 是 is more mildly to express yourself. But 叫, after the verb 叫, you can only put your full name.
Your name.
You cannot put your profession, your nationality, or your title.
Please, thank you. Guys, in the next class, we're going to study yes-no questions ending with ma and questions with interrogative pronoun 哪里 and 哪, which means where, which. We are very interested why you decided to study Chinese. Please write down your reasons. As your teachers, we will be very happy to read your comments. And also, we would like you to encourage to use Chinese different applications to study Chinese. And if you don't have time for that, just listen to Chinese radio. It will help you, even though you do not understand like what they are talking about. In this way, you will just be familiar with Chinese at least. Thank you guys that you are studying Chinese with us. Please push like button on our lessons. It will help more people to know about this class and to study Chinese for free. Thank you. 再见。
再见。